Lindeman track still going here in the indoor season. And wow, what a big event you had, the Collegiate Open here at the Air Force Academy in the field house last weekend, and a great event.
Yeah, we had eight teams in here, and another great experience for our cadet athletes to compete against some outside teams. Cal, Colorado were here, Northern Colorado. We had a really good meet. And you know, I've been telling them every week, we're not a good track team yet. We're not a good track team yet. Well, this last Friday night, we made some great strides to being a really, really good track team. And just a few of the highlights: Ari Martinez in the high jumps. She's a junior. She's just been amazing. She went 5'8". Would be leading the Mountain West if we had a list, you know, to go on this season. And on the men's side, Greg Scoggy in the pole vault, he's now ranked 10th in the nation, 16 go to the NCAA championships. This is the last weekend to qualify. He's got a really good chance. We think Mitch Leip has a chance to qualify as well. He was right behind him this last weekend, and really our pole vaulters really stood out. We're excited about Frankie Parambo and the way that she's been jumping. She's a junior, and she's been jumping really well, making some inroads on our all-time list and so on. And then a freshman, Caden Machtinger, jumped 16.6 this last week. He's gonna be the latest in our pretty long line of really good pole vaulters. Cameron Harris, another really good hurdle race out of the sophomore from Brighton. Our sprinters, we kind of dialed them back a little bit. They had a week off for contact tracing, and they ran again this last week. And so we're excited to watch them, you know, coming up this next week. But at least they got their wheels going a little bit this last weekend. And we're really excited with some of our young throwers, sophomore Hayden Bullock and sophomore Jarrett Preet. Those guys are going to be impactful as we get into the outdoor season and then this week as well. So I thought we made great strides to being a really good track team, and we'll find out this week.
Yeah, I'll say. Championships at the Peak, you're calling it. The third home meet for you here indoors. You don't normally usually have one a year.
Yeah.
But you're kind of the savior for indoor track, getting teams to come in. You got quite a few signed up to come, right?
Yeah, and you know, I'm going to tell you about the teams and everything, but the most important thing about this meet is it's a championship experience for the 100 cadet athletes on our team. And that's why we set it up, and the thing's been a big hit across our conference and with some other conferences. But it's about being able to see some smiles on our kids' faces. And without a Mountain West Conference championship, we're treating it like a championship meet. And with such things, we're going to have, you know, nice awards to match what the Mountain West would normally do. We're going to give T-shirts and hats to the championship teams. And we're just really playing it upright. It's going to be a time schedule almost exactly will mirror what the Mountain West would normally do. So it's an alternative to our normal Mountain West Conference indoor championships that would be this weekend in Albuquerque. And we're giving our kids a championship experience. But in so doing, it's been wildly popular. And the crazy thing is that 8 Mountain West schools, 7 besides ourselves, have indicated their interest in competing. Many of them have already entered. We'll find out. I know a few are still trying to get approvals from administrations, but I believe there will be 8 Mountain West Conference teams represented in the meet. So that's awesome. It's a great alternative for them as well. And then this is the shocker, 8 teams from the Pac-12. We were standing at 7, and yesterday late afternoon I got a message from Stanford that they were interested in coming. So we have Arizona, Arizona State, Colorado, USC, UCLA, Oregon, and Stanford all committed to bringing athletes to the meet. So we're going to see the Arizona State's American collegiate record holder in the shot put, who set that record 2 weeks ago at Texas Tech. And some amazing fields. One I want to mention is, so USC, their top male sprinter is named Brendan Stewart. And Brendan is the son of Todd Stewart, who ran for me my first year at the Air Force Academy in 1990. And I wish Todd could come out and watch him, but with no spectators. Maybe we'll figure out a way to get him to be able to watch. But it's going to be an amazing meet. Wichita State from the American Athletic, Tulane, SMU from the American Athletic, And then our rival, longtime rival, former Mountain West rival, BYU, from the West Coast Conference, and they're coming to try to win the meet as well. You know, some teams are treating it honestly like a final qualifying meet for the NCAA. Others are coming, you know, are all in on it and entering full teams and want to win the meet. And I know Wichita State would like to do that, and Colorado State, and BYU. So it'll be a great challenge. Our kids are excited about it. They deserve this kind of competition. Again, it's a championship experience for them in lieu of a normal year having a Mountain West Conference meet in Albuquerque.
It's almost like a mini NCAA championships, it seems like. But you mentioned you've been doing a good job streaming. I know Matt has really set up streaming recently, and I know he's going to try and do it this weekend, so people might be able to see even though they can't come watch.
Yeah, Matt Layton from our staff has done an amazing job of this. He when we knew we weren't going to have spectators early in the season in January, set it up for our first meet. He's got five camera positions all around the field house. This last week, his latest innovation was he was able to put graphics on the bottom of the screen like you would see on ESPN or whatever. And this week, we're going to do a little better job dabbing into Tom Weston's call of the meet. Tom Weston, the voice of the Mountain West Conference, of course. And so we'll have the audio coming straight from him. And we hope our parents and our alums will all get a chance to watch a championship-style meet, the championships at the peak.
Hats off to Matt. And have you told your team the caliber and all of the teams that are coming in to compete against them?
Yeah, you know, we had a team meeting with them on Saturday morning. And we had practice on Saturday morning. We had a team meeting with them. And team meetings are kind of strange these days. They spread out through the whole field house, and we use a microphone, and every one of our coaches talks into the microphone. And but we let them know about it, and their mouths just, you know, their jaws just dropped. It's like, whoa, really? You know, USC, really? Oregon, seriously? You know, and New Mexico and Nevada and UNLV, and UNLV is going after it for the women's title. You know, they're the reigning Mountain West Conference indoor champs from last year, as is CSU on the men's side. And they're going after the meet, and so it's going to have all different elements of superstar individuals, some great teams, and a exciting team championship race on both the men's and women's side.
Final question I have for you is: what do you want to see your athletes do besides have fun?
Yeah, I want to see them have fun, but I want to see a busload of personal best for the indoor track season. If we were going into a conference meet, I'd tell them the goal is to have 50% of you have your best performance of the indoor season. And if you can have that, you got a good chance at winning a championship. And so that's our goal. And we want to see a whole bunch of seasonal bests and PRs. You know, if we do that on the men's side, I think we can win the meet. If we do that on the women's side, I think we can be in the top three or four teams.
Fantastic. Ralph Lindeman, thanks for the time. Have fun this week.
Great. Okay. Thank you, Brian.